Imagine you are given a table showing the friendships between two people in a group, and you are assigned to split this group into groups of two. Ideally, we want to group people who already know each other into a group. However, it is difficult to do so by just looking at the table. Wouldn't it be nice if you could visualize their connections using an interactive network graph like this? That is when pyvis comes in handy. Pyvis is a Python library that allows you to create interactive network graphs in a few lines of code. In this video, you will learn how to use pyvis to create some helpful interactive graphs. To install pyvis, type pip install pyvis. The article and code for this video can be found in the description of this video. To use pyvis, we will start with installing network from pyvis network. To create a network graph, start with instantiating the network object. Since I want to visualize the graph in my notebook, I will set notebook equal true and CDN resources to be remote. To add nodes to the network graph, we will use the addNode method, whose first argument is the ID of the node and the second argument is a label of the node. And we will add two different nodes. To show the graph and save it to a file, we will call the method show with the file name. Let's run this and see what we get. We have two nodes. One is Alex and one is Kathy. We can interact and move these nodes around. If you want to add a list of nodes instead, use the method addNodes, whose the first argument is a list of nodes and the second argument is a list of labels. To add some colors to the nodes, we will specify the color for the color argument. And we can see nodes with different colors. Currently, there are only nodes. Let's add edges between these nodes. To add an edge to the graph, we will use the addEdge method, which tests a source node and a destination node. To add multiple edges, we will use the addEdges method. And this is how the output looks like. From the graph, we can see that Kathy is linked to both Oliver and Olivia, while Alex is linked to both Oliver and Olivia. This is pretty cool. But what if some edges have larger weights than the others? For example, Alex may be closer to Oliver than Olivia. We can specify the weight of each edge by adding the parameter value to the addEdge method or by adding the third value to each tuple in the list of edges. Since 2 represents Kathy and 5 represents Oliver, we should expect the edge connecting Kathy and Oliver to be the thickest, and the graph confirms what we expected. Hey, if this video has been helpful for you so far, I would love it if you click the like button. This will help my channel spread to more people. Thank you. Now let's apply what we have learned so far to visualize a real social network. We will use the Facebook data, which contains the friend list from Facebook. The link to the dataset can be found in the description of this video. After downloading the data, unzip and save it as facebook-combined.txt. Since this dataset is huge, we will only visualize 1,000 samples from this dataset. And this is how the first 10 rows look like. Let's create a network graph for this dataset by setting the nodes to be a unique list of people in the dataset, and using the values of each row as the source and destination nodes for each edge. We will also use dark background color and white font color. The output graph looks pretty cool. Now, there are a lot of nodes and edges in this graph. Is there a way that we can filter nodes and edges? Yes, you can do that by setting select menu equal true and filter menu equal true. Now, you have a filter bar and a select bar. Let's select a node by specifying the ID of the node. We can see that pyvis highlights the chosen node and its adjacent edges and nodes. We can also change the graph physics by calling the method show buttons filter equal physics. After running the code, you will see a lot of physics settings like this. Let's increase the central gravity and see what we get. Huh, this looks pretty interesting. Our nose tries to get to the middle because the gravity in the center of the graph increases. Now, if we move the central gravity back to normal, the graph looks normal again. If we increase the spring length, we will see that the distance between the nose increases. I encourage you to play with other settings here to get the effect that you want. If you want to reproduce the effect, click Generate Options, copy the dictionary, and paste it on Network Set Options. That's it about pyvis. Since it only takes several lines of code to create a beautiful network graph, why don't you give it a try? It is essential to create an effective graph because it can unpack so much helpful information. In this video, you will learn how to add statistical significance annotations on your Python plots. Thank you for listening.